So one of the things that people like to talk about, the difference between print and digital, is that when you, most comics are now colored on computers, and the vibrancy of your computer, the colors are really rich and intense and have a lot of subtleties. Well, that doesn't translate to printing, especially depending on how cheap you are printing it. The colors get saturated, they get muted, so they're not as vibrant. So the colors on your iPad or your tablet or, you know, whatever, is almost identical to what it is that you're seeing on your computer screen. So the vision of the colorist can be maintained better digitally than it can through print. And there's some people that have actually done, you know, on the web, they've actually compared the print version to the digital version. So that's one of the advantages. Now, one of the disadvantages of digital is that we have a lot of creators, especially within Submit, who create comics black and white because that's the cheapest way to publish and distribute them. So we get a lot of black and white comics, which is great. However, straight black and white comics don't look great on the iPad because there's no gradations, there's no subtleties. It's all just black and white line art. So they aren't as impressive digitally as they are in print because, you know, it's obviously a different experience. So what you're probably going to start seeing is that because print is no longer the barrier to reaching your audience, you're going to see people starting to do things that they wouldn't normally do because they don't have to worry about print. You know, coloring books that they wouldn't normally color, or taking event. I mean, one of the advantages of digital is that you don't have to tell stories in four-page signatures. You know, it's like in a print book, you have your signatures, each has four pages on it. You have to make sure that the length of the book matches those signature counts, and then whatever ads or whatever else you have in there. So you could literally have a book that is 13 pages long or 27 pages long. It doesn't have to be, it doesn't have to end in an even number. It can be whatever you want. It doesn't have to be landscape. You could do, it doesn't have to be portrait. You can do a lot of landscape. I like to read on my iPad in landscape mode. And we have a lot of people who are taking advantage of the landscape mode to tell their stories, which is, if you think about it, it's a lot like the Sunday comics. You know, the Sunday comics were told in landscape mode. So you have, you know, an evolution of storytelling because they're not tied to print. There's an evolution of, you know, outreach because, you know, you're not limited to the people that you can reach with your physical copies. You can, you know, go online. You can, you know, one of the really nice things about our website is that we have a link that you can point to anywhere in the world, and then they can go and find your comic and buy it. You know, you're at a bar and you're meeting some people. You're like, hey, I've got this great comic. You should check it out. They're like, oh, where can I get it? Be like, it's right here on my iPad. Here, take this link. You can then download it. They could read it there in the bar while you're there. You know, it's just this digital has opened up like essentially the world to anyone who wants to participate.